because there's been a lot going on. But I would like to thank everyone for coming to Anime NYC this past weekend. And really like to thank all of you who came to the table. It's really nice to see all of you. Those of you who came this to my panel at Connecticut Con to hear me speak on a particular subject that I enjoy. And for those of you who I had no idea and were really fans of the blog, honestly, I really didn't think I was going to continue dealing with our online magazine because I was the only one writing articles and I wasn't really getting much feedback. And at Anime NYC, a bunch of people were actually looking for our table because they knew we were there every year, and it was just asking me so many questions on the blog, you know, how I got the idea to make it, the backstory. I mean, I found out a young man was using our blog to help him with his Japanese classes. I had no idea. I'm not very proficient in Japanese. A lot of times, I'm really just, if there's a name of an anime in Japanese, okay, you know, here's what we call it in America. This is what we call it in Japanese. This is actually its Japanese name. And this is what the characters actually translate to. And if it's using kanji, maybe I'll go in a little bit more detail. Okay, well, this kanji actually means this, this, and this. So one of the reasons why we changed the name is because it means this in Japanese. It makes no sense in English. And it's just better to change the name to something that would make more sense. Little stuff like that. So I explain that stuff in our blog. I have a habit of using at least three resources before publishing an article to make sure the article is factual. We are going to continue to do this. I'm not giving up on the blog like I had planned to. I would say at this point, we are going to continue to do things where we are. We're still going to use the MLA format to produce the articles. We're going to have three or more sources for the article to keep up with the idea of being professional in terms of the journalism that we do. And, of course, and then, you know, we have our other products. You know, I've been very busy with the computer repair shop. That's how we're staying open. It's also the reason why I'm not going back to work in IT. I've gone out on my own, finally. I have my own shop. I do my own consulting work. I do IT. I repair computers, laptops. I recently started replacing batteries and game cartridges because I have a soldering iron, and why not? This is so that I can work more on this material and not have to have a 9-to-5 job, which in IT, my job was never really 9-to-5. It was more like 8:30 in the morning to 10 o'clock at night if there was an outage, or maybe even till the next morning if there was a really bad problem. Let me just turn it off. I'd like to say, I'm going to start putting up our Patreon page. We're going to start doing things like our passive income so that I don't have to go back to work and I give more time to you guys. That's my ultimate goal. So I can give more time to this material. Upcoming review on our blog, we'll be talking about the new Cowboy Bebop live action. I would talk about it now on the live stream. I just don't know how many of you really are ready to talk about this. Cowboy Bebop live action, and I'm going to say I like it. The Cowboy Bebop live action has kept the essence of the show, but it's 20 years later, a little bit over 20 years later, since the show aired, and the original creators worked on the live action. Let's not be coy about this. The original creators of Cowboy Bebop worked on the show alongside the creative team that created the live action. And their choices of actors at this point has to be perfect. They're portraying the characters very well. I've seen a lot of negative reviews out there. I think you need to not compare the two. Understand, you know what? It's like comparing Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy. You have Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy started off as a radio series on the BBC. It was not a book, not a novel, until after the radio series aired. And listen to the old tapes of the radio series and then move forward to the novelization and the original BBC TV series of Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy, they're very different from each other. Douglas Adams refined the story from there and then. And then if you compare all of that material to the final Hitchhiker's Guide Galaxy to the movie that was made just before he died, that's a refinement of even that story. The story has constantly been refined. So sometimes creators, when they work on a piece for over 30 years, 20 years, they refine the story to something more. People forget, in the early 90s, Cowboy Bebop was very rushed in terms of getting an episode out each week. And some of the characters were not always fleshed out. And yes, it's a great series. I'm still a fan of the original. I still prefer the original anime. But you need to give this show a shot because they did very good. This same crew is going to be producing One Piece. Right? You heard it here. You know, we talked about it. A bunch of us were talking about it. And was pretty much announced this whole year. It's been announced at the different anime conventions. So we've known this. And Cowboy Bebop was their first taste of doing this, and in my opinion right now, they have done a good enough job to where I am actually going to give the One Piece live action a try. I have no idea, considering the powers that the Gum Gum Fruit gives different people. There are many different characters in One Piece that have eaten the fruit and have obtained a variety of different powers that just makes the characters really interesting. I don't know how much they're going to have to use CG, or maybe they'll use some kind of puppeteering, or maybe another type of new type of special effect method that will make it more realistic. I'm going to assume it's going to be some type of more realistic CG for a lot of things, but I see why they started with Cowboy Bebop. One Piece is going to be, cinematography-wise, a very difficult shoot. There were choices made in the Cowboy Bebop live action that certain scenes were changed completely because filming them would require a certain type of timing training, particularly training the dog, Ayn, the corgi that's in the show, and getting that corgi. And corgis are not the easiest dogs to train in terms of movies. You're better with shepherds and sheepdogs, like collies and stuff like that. Dogs that were specifically designed to be used in film or trained. So training animals and getting animals to do something on cue on set, that doesn't always happen. So there's certain scenes that just could not be filmed. There were changes made to the show so you could focus on the three main characters. And I think that's a better change. If all four characters were in the show, you would have to give equal amount of time to all four characters, and this show has a shorter runtime than the original, even though they've already greenlighted the second season, so you've got more material coming. But I, like I said to everybody, before we get into our game, because we're going to start Cyberpunk 2077 again, this time I want to change my character again. I want them to kind of match my hair. And right now, they're still not offering us to do in-game facial changes and changes to the characters once they're created. Just kind of hoping they're going to do that. Also, apparently, I have a download available for free. Oh, it's installed already. They did it for me. Oh, I got some new jackets and stuff. I have a new car. I'm not that far in the game where it's really going to matter to me. But let's go back and let's do this. We'll go back over in the tutorials. If anyone has any questions, I'm watching a live stream here. Just let me get the game capture up. Oh, the game capture is up. So this is going to launch when I launch the game. I still don't have everything quite ready. So I've been playing around with the new templates and the new layover overlays for Streamlabs. Yes, our fiasco with XSplit is over. And the other thing we'll be filming in the next few weeks before my college classes start again we'll be filming Gamers Upgrade, and I hope all of you, we will not be doing that in a live stream. That will be strictly a film YouTube channel video where gamer, the machine I'm playing, is getting an upgrade. Matter of fact, she won't even be in the same case. My big thing of lately is, I recently rebuilt a couple of gaming machines, and I have saved up and bought some additional parts. So most of Gamers, all of Gamers' parts are there. I may get one more graphics card and get the same type of graphics card that I bought for Gamer, which is an RTX card. I'm going to see if Micro Center will have one more. Unfortunately, Micro Center right now, I've got to wait a month before I buy something, and I am now in my month where I can buy another graphics card for Gamer, even though I want to take older parts and use one PC to do this stream. So Gamer will run the game going forward once it's up, and then I'll build another computer to actually run the stream. That should be better. Until then, I will be placing a second RTX card in Gamer and setting up Streamlabs to process the stream through that card and run the game through the other card. This is not the best, but Gamer, I don't have to worry about power issues, because that is a power issue, it's a heat issue. But Gamer, the new Gamer's new power supply is a 1,000-watt power supply. I made the effort to get a 1,000-watt gold power supply. This is a higher-end power supply. There's more than enough power in Gamer's current 800-watt power supply to run her. It came in while I was in Micro Center a few weeks ago, and as much as it cost me, I had to grab it. I have an AMD 9300 with the new AMD RGB Ray fan that comes with it. So Gamer is not going to be in her old black case. We have a deep cool tempered glass case. So, and because now you can see inside Gamer, I'm really going with RGB lighting. This will be an RGB cooled system we will be doing. Air cooled system. I'm still not a fan of, I've repaired two machines with the AIO cards, and so far the thing I don't like is when an AIO card breaks, there's no warning that it's not cooling your CPU, and I've literally had to replace an entire motherboard and CPU because a young man didn't monitor his temperature inside of the computer, and for a year, his computer ran hot for over a year and just broke. The motherboard had to be replaced, and the CPU had to be replaced. So, Gamer's new case and body will be RGB fans, a series of them, all color-wise, and I'm rebuying Gamer's RAM to have RGB RAM sticks in. So she'll be AMD about 9300 RGB Ray fan on top of her. They're beautiful. They cool very well. I have a new high-end thermal paste. They will be replacing the thermal paste that comes with it. It's that one. It pulls more heat away from the CPU, and then of course I found these additional RGB fans that we're putting inside a case. We will also be using an anime-based case. I haven't decided which one, but since our gaming and hobby shop / computer repair shop is anime-related, I thought that gamers should not have a standard. This will be one of my high-end build PCs for myself, but this design will be for sale by next summer, hopefully. I just want to see how Gamer performs with this configuration. And if this configuration performs well and gets the performance that I'm hoping it gets, I will be selling the design off my website. I will build them, and I will ship them out. I found these great PC boxes that are really durable. And I can also ship keyboards and mice if that's what you really want. Along with the tower. And I really like these new cases, these shipping cases I found for PCs. So that will be our computer store's big thing. Low budget, high end performing gaming PCs to the general public. I'm hoping to have a logo that we'll be placing on the cases by then. And, as you can see, Gamer is running Cyberpunk 2017 with no, other than firmware. I did have to upgrade the firmware on her GPU. This hardware is over, it was all this hardware was put together about 2011. So think about that. I'm running current games on hardware that old, but only 32 gigs of RAM and an Intel i7. So not to tout how good I am at planning these things out, but my designs tend to last a really long time and at a low cost. Though gamers are going to be a little bit more expensive because gamer has a dedicated sound card. I still really love the Sound Blaster cards from Creative Labs. I've been using them since the early, literally, I've been using them since the early 80s when they had the Sound Blaster 8-bit 1, and I haven't stopped using them. The other big change the gamer will be is once she's up, I'll be splurging to show what the Sound Blaster card can do in terms of, I'll be getting a new chair. The newer chair will have speakers in it that will link to the sound card, as well as a 6.1 surround sound system for gamers in the look. We're also, you can't see, but we're redoing the office. The only thing that will have to happen, I'm still working on this, is I do have crypto miners that will be starting up at the end of this month. If they are too loud, the entire streaming system will be moved outside of the computer lab, that's where I film now, and be moved to the new work area I'm building outside. It's full of junk right now. It's outside this room. This room, once the servers are running, because there are server cabinets over here in the corner that you can't see, and we're doing our game hosting, and pretty much this starts functioning as a full data center. I will leave a work computer in here where I'll be editing the video, as well as doing my programming and a lot of my classes. It's pretty much my work area. And we will have a designated area outside. I will bring my console systems down here from the entertainment center upstairs so that we can hook them up to a separate console game when we're doing some classic retro gaming streams as well off the channel through that capture PC for that. So there'll be like two capture PCs that we'll be filming. One for the retro gaming systems, and then one for PC gaming, and of course I will continue to do my live stream. We're actually going to try to set a schedule. We're really going to sit down and set a schedule for the live stream, and there'll be one live stream for me, this channel you're on now, and then Otaku Times itself will have a separate live stream for its reviews. And then Otaku Gaming and Hobby will get a live stream. We'll be actually probably in the beginning we'll just film building model kits. Like we're gonna do some Gundams coming up. And that will be on the Gaming and Hobby stream. If we can stream that live, I'm still not confident in my ability to build a Gundam in front of you guys. I'd rather mess up a few times off on camera, edit it so it looks like I didn't mess up. but once I get better at it, we'll be doing live painting. We'll be doing Gundams. As soon as I get a little bit better, we'll be doing the Warhammer painting. We're going to be painting Warhammer models for the Warhammer game. And we're going to be putting together a couple of things and paint jobs for X-Wing Armada and X-Wing and TIE Fighter tabletop war games. Most of those you don't have to paint, but I've met a few people that have some interesting designs and some interesting layouts that they use in their Star Wars Armada tabletop. And I think it'd be interesting to do that. Again, these are things that we're working on. Please follow us at this point. Keep up with us. Follow our blog. Follow our channels. Follow now. The Patreon page will be up. Please, contribute to the Patreon page. We're going to be trying to send out prints and stuff for people who sign up. Any way you can help out, a small donation, to keep me from going back to work so I can keep producing content for you. And that's the way we're going to go. Alright, so now that we're done with everything that happened, again, thank you for everyone who came to Anime NYC. those of you who are going to be at LA Comic Con, I will be there. I will not have a table. I will be walking around. The only thing I ask is you can come up and talk to me, but this will be Nicole Nichols' last comic book convention, I believe, and I'm dead set on getting Nicole Nichols' autograph. This time, I'm like bending over backwards to make sure I'm able to spend time with Nicole Nichols. I mean, I'll just say it that much. I don't want to talk about things that have been going on with her family or her personal life. She has been sick recently, and you know, she was on the original Star Trek TV series, and I actually have three of her sci-fi novels that I gotta remember to put in my bag. I really would like her to sign those. I have three of her books that I really like her to sign. She's a brilliant sci-fi writer, as well as playing Lieutenant Uhura on Star Trek. And the fact that this is going to be her last time, I'm just like, I am a big open book. Anyone walks up to me at comic convention, I will take pictures of you guys, I will talk to you guys. I will talk to you about anything you want. Our TikTok channel is doing very well. I'm very happy with it. I am surprised you guys even follow me. My content is all over the place, and I guess you guys like that. And I'm going to continue to try to do the best I can for you. As best I can to do things for you and give you the content that I can give you. Normally I would have the other mic available to do this conversation. I have stuff to protect. Unfortunately, since I've been cleaning out the office to put in the new data center, new servers, and the crypto miners, all my mics, because I have a series of mics for different types of podcasts and communications, different sound checks, and they're all in a box right now. So we're going to do our best today with the webcam mic, and let's get back to the world of Cyberpunk 2077. There's been a lot of improvements in the game. A lot of people are still very upset with them. But I have to admit, the game is getting better. I do enjoy it. I was hoping the game would be more like a Shadowrun type of thing. But honestly, Shadowrun Chronicles is just awesome. Shadowrun Returns on Streamlabs. And you know what? We'll do that one next week. Because there are some moments in Shadowrun Returns that if you played the Super Nintendo version of Shadowrun, I don't know how old some of you are, I guess I gave away my age, but I still have my original Shadowrun Super Nintendo cartridge. I played that game, beat the game. That game was brilliant. It really wasn't like the tabletop. There's a lot of rules that you have in the tabletop version of Shadowrun, the RPG, all those rules are just broken in Shadowrun. And honestly, Shadowrun Returns was just horribly broken. But it's such an entertaining game. And I was hoping Cyberpunk 2077 would be more like that. But in its own right, it actually is a very good game. I have enjoyed it. I have not completed the game. I know where I have redone my character so many times. And I'm hoping this last time with you guys, this will be the last time. And going forward, we're going to finish this game. Off and on. So let's get started. This is a Thanksgiving stream that I'm doing quickly. I forgive me not spending time with my my family this Thanksgiving. We will be spending Christmas with them, so there'll be no Christmas live stream. It's just that we couldn't get a cat sitter for our five cats this time around. It's just too late, and my wife isn't feeling well. She just had hip surgery. So, because she had the hip surgery, we're really not traveling all that much. For New York Comic Con, I went back and forth to the house. Normally, I stay at the Four Points Sheraton across from the Javits Center so that I don't have to go back and forth on a train. For New York Comic Con this year, I went back and forth because my wife literally just got out of the hip surgery. So, she really needed help. For NYNYC, of course, you guys know, I was there. After the convention, after I was done at the table, you could catch me at the bar drinking over at the hotel. And that's my staple that I do every year with Anime NYC. We started off with Anime NYC at the very beginning. They started in 2017. We have had a table with them, either Artist Alley, or right now we do the exhibition hall because of the new rule changes to Artist Alley. Every year since then, we've always been at Anime NYC, and we will continue to be at Anime NYC. We both started, and we basically created each other within the same year and time frame. So we're going to keep up this tradition. There will be no more afternoon margaritas, which was a staple. I know you guys love me doing that. But there are no more margarita machines in the Javits Center, and I am not bringing in margaritas to the Javits Center. I'm sorry about that. There are a couple reasons why I'm not doing my afternoon margarita. I would just have the one, but we would film it. Like, okay, here's a picture of the afternoon margarita. And of course, the Javits Center used to do these big margaritas, not little ones. They weren't as big as, say, you go to Dallas Barbecue and get the Texas-sized margarita, but, they were good. Too much sugar, too. I've got to cut back on my sugar. Alright, so I think we're done rambling. So let me get the game launched. And go. You couldn't free up any RAM? Jeez. We're not going to be playing too long. I do have to... I don't know yet. I was going to get up and cook today. I'm honestly not feeling it. I'm sorry. I'm honestly not feeling the cooking. There we go. She's launching. Yeah, I'm sorry, guys. I'm just not feeling like cooking today. So me and my wife will most likely be going across the street to Parson Diner every year. They do this great Thanksgiving dinner for like $30 or $60 for two people. You get like a 3-course meal, dessert, and everything else. So yeah, I think it is. Sure, which one? I want my home pick. They've added more. They used to take this on the cycle back. Don't actually have that's really kind of sucky. To allow you to mess with that a bit. This is a live stream, so we're getting down to the part we should really be careful. Why do I say be careful? Yeah, why do I say be careful? You'll see in a minute. Okay, we're gonna exit out now before I get kicked out. So we got 7 points. This will be my last build. Won't do this anymore.
Hey everyone, it feels great to have you back. So then, did you all hear about that Arasaka aircraft carrier docked in Night City called Kujira, or the Whale? Apparently the group figured it was safe in Japanese waters. Afraid some local fishermen might harpoon it for scientific research.
Put the remote control on now.
Wonder what Mutek will respond with. Maybe Myers will fly a rust bucket B-17 Flying Fortress over Arasaka HQ. Oh man, that is insensitive. I am so sorry. Where are my manners? President Myers, I mean, of course. Gotta respect the office. Anywho.
Go.
Listen, I've got a problem. Serious.
Shark with business eggs. Sounds too good to be true.
Well, Merry fucking Christmas.
How's your problem? Cut him some slack, will you? You'll pay. Just need some more time.
Do I look like a priest that runs a charity to you? You borrow Eddie's. You gotta pay him back. With interest. It's common fucking knowledge. Suggesting I let a flaky cunt who can't keep a deal off the hook?
No, you let him off because it's me asking.
Huh, you know me. I'm a man of the biz. So I need to know what I get out of it.
Transactions go two ways, I get that. I'll owe you a favor. Stealing a ride like that would be a level beyond me. Hell, two levels.
Beautiful thing is, a Grand Theft Auto virgin like you don't need to know how. I already planned it. Whole thing's simple. You swipe the race field for me, I clear Pepe's account. Even tossing a cut for you, I'm such a nice guy. My man Rick works a parking structure by Embers, club where our race field driver likes to take you. There every Friday night, like clockwork. As soon as you appear, security cam shut down, gate swings up, the rogue is yours. Just gotta grab the Rayfield and roll out. Simple.
Who's the owner?
Just an Arasaka suit from across the water. Spews cash out of every hole in his body.
And his name?
How would I know? Why would I care? It's a hot item and I know where to find it.
Plan sounds shaky as fuck.
Oh, how so?
Sounds like you're looking for a sucker.
This ain't no setup fee. Heard you got a good head. Maybe we help each other make a few eggs.
And your man, Rick.
Trust him like my own brother.
How am I supposed to do this? Expect me to slide into the chassis on a skateboard for a quick hot wire? Fast and easy? Curved wheels like this got security systems. Good ones.
This big bot works like a key Rayfield text used for repairs. Opens locks, bypasses identity authorization.
A skeleton key for all Rayfields in the city. Even you don't buy that.
Kabuki's tech wizards sell more magical shit than this under the counter. Have a little faith. So, we all agreed then.
We are.
Glad to hear you. Always said you were bright. Head to Embers in the Glen. Rick's in the garage. We wait for you. You two will hit it off. Good luck out there. We'll be in touch.
Fat-ass motherfucker.
Hey, why do I see no goddamn lemons, no goddamn limes? They're in there, for sure.
You. All yours.
You know what's so good in you. God bless.
Back from Atlanta a few weeks ago.
See, you got a good damn homework. How was it, my geese?
Tell you later. Got something on my plate.
I'll bone you from here now. You're right.
Marcus, let's go.
So where to?
The Glen. Drop me off at Embers.
Front door?
Take the ramp back of the bar. Show you where to stop.
You heard him, Marcus. Your return to NC has been good. Busy already?
I picked up something here and there. Nothing major. But I'm getting by. Appreciate the concern.
So, I planted it like you expected.
Went there without expectations, actually. Well, except that it'd be better than here. But it wasn't.
Maybe it all worked out for the best.
Well,
should be a bar now.
Looks like it's my lucky day.
What do you want?
To settle our biz once and for all. Got an offer for you, Pat. So listen up. Get the fuck out of Vista. Pull your boys off the street. I'll give you the Glen. Done deal. No more restless nights. See how generous I can be.
One more fucking word.
Stay out of this.
I don't know you.
And I don't know you. Which means you were shit around here and capable of even less.
Well, anything else?
He seems our conversation has come to a close.
Careful, Padre. You neither, shit bucket.
Marcus, please. I'm pleased to see you. So many of the little shits left around here, despite the sword that I would have had.
Who was that?
No one important. He'll be gone in a week's time. Another will come in his place.
Pulled iron on him.
He did. And he will pay for doing so.
Right here. I'll just drop down below.
Here.
You know.
Could be useful. Maybe we can also work together again. Take ourselves back 2 years.
Thanks, Audrey. Gotta go.
So go with God.
B? Status.
On location. I'm about to find your man.
Rick's one of the good guys. We'll see. I trust him like a brother.
Yeah, so he said.
Something I can help you with.
Curves.
Camera's playing. You've got 20 minutes. Do your thing.
Kirk, I see the ride.
Your moment to shine, Joe. Good luck.
Let's take this piece of wonder tag for a world.
You're a man of little faith. See? We're rich.
Oh,
dinner is trash. Gotta make custody, Mr. Ujoka. We'll be taken. It's a waste of effort. I have no time to testify or play in an investigation. Suggesting we let him go, sir, I suggest you toss them in the sea. Conflict rose from this trash.
He's Hayward born-bred and grown like us. He hates suits as much as you do. Do what you have to do. That's it.
If I hadn't come, we'd be cruising Night City in sexy wheels right now.
Nah, come on. Job was toxic and stuff. Even Kabuki under the counter magic can't get around a lawn like that. Should have known I'd have the BD on my ass.
So, maybe now, as God ordained. Jackie Wells.
V.
I know you. You hang at the Coyote.
Got the job to seal those wheels at the Coyote. And Kirk.
You work with that sewer slug?
Pepe owes him big, can't afford to pay, so I stepped up.
I wonder about Pep letting slimy Kirk boss him around like that.
Heard what they say. He's backed by cartels.
Cartels? No, listen. I know those cartel types, and I guarantee you, none of them have even heard of Kirk. And we've got one guy to learn. He don't do people in Hayward dirty. Come on. Let's go have some lunch.
Just like that? Put a barrel in my skull not so long ago.
You help my homies. You're okay in my book. Don't harm no foul.
None at all.
Get in one of my good feelings.
About what?
About us. It's the kind of chemistry. Come on. I'm fucking starved.
Okay. Food it is. Let's go.
Stanley here with you, and we got another day ahead of us in this city of dreams. Ooh, I love this town. Love it like you might love a mother who popped you out on the steps of an orphanage once and now stops you to ask if you got a smoke for her. Every new day here meets 100 new arrivals, but only half these gossels survive a year, and that's a good one. And why do these peeps come to NC? Well, to be street samurai like Morgan Blackhand and Wheeling Boba Boba. No greater the risk, no bigger the mountain, kids. Or so they say. But you can only be a major league player for so long. The faster you land, the faster you burn out. If you don't get a bullet to the brain first. Legends! Know where you'll find most of them? The graveyard! Matters not where you're from! Matters not where you start! What matters here is the walk you walk! In Night City! The City of Dreams!
We're looking for her somewhere in this building. Probably crawling with the Pinocchio's the kidnapper. Eyes and ears open, right? Speaking of which, got you a little something. A little tech training shard. In case you need to brush up on your dad's moves. Number
some target practice in VR?
Sure. Why the hell not?
Let's begin with basic combat training. This session will be recorded for subsequent evaluation. This course is designed to reinforce your fundamental combat abilities and hone your reflexes. The skills you gain here will help you survive, even excel on the battlefield. I will train you to be effective with firearms, to use stealth tactics to advantage, and to hack into enemy networks. Because at Militech...
Man, Militech can't encrypt for shit. But they clearly got drill and jarheads in their blood. Now, Station 1, you maggot! Move, move, move! Hope you're ready to bust ass through this fascist playground. Let's last with a tactical target practice program. You know, a little warm up. Hacking to the next item on the menu. This training module will teach you how to apply technical work a little hack magic on the screen to distract the boss. Especially the dead kind. Now pick up the body and hide it somewhere. Okay. Now try to take him down in one slick move. Okay. street's not going to give you any hints or second chances. Right. So first, let's shape up those stealth skills. With the camera.
Who
this. I did this full stuff.
So? Not bad, huh?
Now, now we can get down to business.
Let's do this.
Dorset. Target's biomonitor viewed a couple hours back. Suspected abduction. Target could have possibly flatlined already. Not sure you're in time.
We're in time, Buck. We. Sure you're on phone, but that don't make you any less part of this squad.
Squad. Charming.
Buck, could at least try to be nice.
You want nice, supportive? Call the damn helpline.
Sandra Dorset's protected under Echelon 2 Corporal Unity. Our crew's top shelf. This one's packed with black market sale tech repos. Typical back alley fix ups.
Not a lucky gal. Let's keep looking.
Thank you.
still home. Move on. Look. I'm behind you, V.
Stealth this time.
Jesus fucking Christ.
I think I got her. Got her target.
We make it? Is she alive?
About to find out.
V, jacking for a biomon. You need to know what we're doing.
Jacking in.
This little monster.
Sandra Dorsett, NC570442, Trauma Team Platinum.
Platinum? Shit. Trauma should have swooped in if she sneezed.
Guess I can jam with the transmitter sick. Looking at a hacked bottom on, where we can be for a neurovirus.
Rock with debug. You ain't seeing this place. This is tubs, ice, hooks, cleaners.
Trauma will be here in 3 minutes.
Your premium plan will cover 90% of the projected costs of your rescue and treatment.
Let's get her off that ice.
Shit, it worked.
Listen, Mano, I got this thing. Mind if I borrow your wheels? I got a date with Misty, but I can't take the metro. How's it gonna look for me?
Only be hanging, Jack. But don't.
Get used to it. Hello.
have you home, huh? She's all yours. I'm beat as it is.
She's alive well. That's what we agreed, isn't it?
Splendid. Your payment awaits you. Ready to come and grab whenever you like, even right away. But I guess home is the only place you wish to be now. The NCPD has surrounded Watson. The district is closed. If you are to make it past the quarter, you must move fast.
Thanks for the heads up. Swing by and see you later. What's happening?
Legends are born here. Starving. Let's grab a tight bite. What do you say?
Jackie, they're locking down Watson. It's okay. You can wait. Let's just focus on getting home.
officer!
Ma'am! Ma'am, are we ever lucky we ran into him?
What is it that makes him so special?
Heart of gold. Because only somebody with a heart of gold can understand just how much I need to get back with my girl. Uh-huh. I'm gonna be worried sick about the show. I mean, you tried to be a stand-up guy. Giving me a chance. Wait.
That's a shame.
Look at him. No mob citizen, mate. But he's a good kid.
Let them through. But they can laugh. Okay. On your way.
You have a good evening now, officer. Ma'am.
So you can be nice if you like.
What am I not nice?
Always?
I'm always never not nice.
Your average badges. Max Attic. CDs, Apex Predators.
M-Tech rolls in when things fly out of hand. Dogs aren't there long. Just a bit day sack world. Well, she was over. Old bastards. They had it coming. Sweet dreams, then.
Tell Misty I said hi.
I will. I will.
Alright, we're going to end here for tonight. There's still a few error delays, and I've dropped a few packets. 71 is less than before, but I want to get this configured. I want to thank everyone for coming. I'm going to close it out. We'll do some more, and we'll take off. We'll start off from where we left off yesterday.